What every Russian schoolboy knows.
Good time of day to all of you, my chess friends here on the Internet Chess Club. This is Grandmaster Alex Chermolinsky. Welcome back. What every Russian schoolboy knows. I'm going to continue my series of coulda, woulda, shoulda when I talked about players who for one reason or another could not fulfill their true potential and they didn't get to play World Championship match and therefore they did not become World Champions. We already talked about Harry Nelson Pillsbury, Klaus Junge and Leonid Stein. Now time to get a little bit closer to our times and here where I'm gonna totally lose my objectivity. Well, I'm gonna go totally subjective on you guys. And no, I do have a choice of players. Although it gets a little bit confusing, right? When we talk about any time since 1993. Because then we had the split in FIDE. And or different events were titled World Championship matches. And it went all the way, you know, to until, I guess, until the that match between Kramnik and Anand, right? Won by Anand. No, so Anand became undisputed champion. But that was, what, 2007 or 2008? I don't even remember. Anyways, a long stretch, 15 years of confusing times over there. And therefore, you know, it would be a little hard for me to make a show, say, about Topalov and say that Topalov didn't become a world champion for one reason or another. No, he thinks he was a world champion. He won the tournament in San Luis. Or at least that's what his manager, Danilov, thinks. Or, I don't know, I thought of going with Shirov, obviously, it would be a logical candidate. But then again, you know, like, I mean, talking about people who are still alive, you know, am I burying them? You know, maybe they just prepare and then they're going to make their... they're going to make another effort, you know. Maybe they're going to make it for real this time. And that should include Shirov as well. But then again, I don't know, I kind of ran out of dead people too. Then I decided to make a controversial decision and go along with a man that probably not too many people would be considered worthy including in this list, you know, for various reasons. And this man also is my personal friend. That's Grandmaster Valery Salov. All right, okay, this is the moment when you don't like Salov's anti-Semitic views and statements that he made. This is where you turn this video off, because I am not gonna apologize for whatever Salov said, simply because this is a chess show. Let me go on with that. Now, Salov hails from same town as I am. That would be Leningrad, now St. Petersburg. Now, Salov is 6 years younger than me, yet he made his name known in Leningrad chess circles by the time he was 13. That's when we met and played for the first time. That was rather unimportant at the collegiate team competition, and Salov played for Leningrad University. And... that was an interesting game, actually. I was winning in that game. I was 19 years old and obviously a better player. But somehow in the rook endgame, I made one inaccurate move and incredible defense by that scrappy young player. And that was it. The game was drawn. And there are many games like this. Well,